Abhishek. Okay, we could open.
So guys, I am all set for my last day in Bangkok. I have packed my bag and everything, and I would be going to the 7th floor to have the breakfast and then come up, take my bag and then check out of the hotel. So let's go.
Guys, here we are at the Wat Pho complex, which is known for the temple of reclining Buddha, for the largest reclining gold plated Buddha. it is also the oldest part and the learning center in Bangkok. The total area of Wat Pho complex is around 80,000 square meter. To the west lies the Reclining Buddha, and to the east there are several chapels and the famous Wat Pho massage school. So here we are entering the Prabuddha Chinnashri, the West Assembly Hall. We can see Lord Buddha sitting on a mujarin tree, and he is protected by a seven-headed nag. The name of the nag is said to be Muchalinda, and it is a very serene place and people come here for praying.
Hello guys, so I am at Wat Pho to see the Reclining Buddha, and you can see the temple behind me. This has a very giant statue of a Buddha who is sleeping, so it is called as Reclining Buddha. And this is the temple. Here we are entering the temple of Reclining Buddha, which is also called the Prabuddha Sayas. Now one thing to notice that it was a weekend, so it was very much crowded. So if you want to take some good photos or videos, do plan ahead and go on a weekday rather than going on a weekend.
Dress code has to be followed at Wat Pho. Everyone, whether men or women, should wear a long sleeve top and long trousers. All shoes should have the toe covered as well. Now, for the Reclining Buddha, if you are exposing your leg or shoulder, you will be refused entry until you cover them. So, shawls are available on site. Shoes have to be removed while entering into to see the reclining Buddha and any bot. The reclining Buddha statue is made up of brick and stucco. It is 46 meters in length and 15 meters in height from the base to the top knot. The feet are 5 meters long and 3 meters high. After exploring the Wat Pho complex, we headed for some shopping at the CentralPlaza Pinklao mall, which is in Noi district of Bangkok. After doing some shopping at the CentralPlaza Pinklao mall, we headed for the SuvanraBhumni International Airport as we had a flight to catch to Mumbai. Guys, one thing you will notice while staying in Bangkok is that even in heavy traffic, you will not see anyone honking. In my total 3 days in Bangkok, I never heard anyone honking, even when we were stuck up in a very heavy traffic.